Today we're going to be taking a look at a Raptor. Not that Raptor, this Raptor. This has been released from Horizon Vape Distro and EHPro. We're going to dive down below. When we come back up top, I'll tell you a little bit more about it. I'll see you back here in a minute. Let's take a look at the Raptor. As you can see, this is a sample pack, a reviewer's pack, and it's from Horizon Vape Distro and made in collaboration with EHPro. Just to get it out of the box, and as you can see, it says Raptor on there, and we're just going to correct this and I'll explain when we go back up top, but it is actually a Raptor. But your packaging will be Raptor, not Rapture. So let's open up the box. Nice, clean, crisp packaging, as you would expect. Not much else to really see on here. So let's look inside. And inside you will find your O-rings, your bubble glass, your extension bubble glass. And then you will also find a spare 0.2 ohm coil for 60 to 80 watts vaping, which is a dual coil. These are mesh and seagrass. The coil I've got installed is a 0.15 and it's just a single mesh. Looking around, you can see you've got the logo on the bottom there with your serial number. And you've got your static 510 pin, you've got your airflow ring and what opens on one side. As every reviewer tells you, typically it opens up on the other. So if you close it on one side, it closes on the other side. Ta-da! There we go. Looking at the top, you've got an 810 drip tip and very nicely done. It's a nice resin look to it. Makes it feel a bit stylish. You can use your own drip tips in here as well. Let's put that back in. And to fill up the tank, you simply find the arrow. There it is. And you just push it over to reveal the kidney hole. And you pump and squirt and squeeze your juice into the tank. But as you can see, it's got the TPD glass on here. And I'm not convinced with it. I'm not entirely happy with it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show you my coil. I've been using this for about 3 or 4 weeks. I'm just going to take it apart. It really is simple to take apart. There's minimal moving bits on it. And looking at my coil, as you can see, this is the Raptor 0.15 coil. And ideal wattage for this, I think they state it's about 40 to 50 watts, but I've been running to about 50 and had it about 4 weeks in there and it's still going. I'm only changing it because I want to try a different juice. But as you can see, it's pretty caramelized. Looking around it, there you go, look. It's still got some life left in it. The cotton is not fully black all the way through. And what's unique about this is it is made from seagrass. But we'll talk about that when we go back up top. Just going to take a look at the other parts. We've got the base, the deck, and very cleanly machined, very crisp threads. The top is the same. And then you've got the glass, the TPD glass, I'm not a big fan of. And it goes together quite easy. I'm going to put the bubble glass in. And I just want to show you with the coils, what I like to do is once I've threaded it in, I just like to scratch up the surface, not pierce them, but I just like to scratch the surface to help with wicking. So if I grab a pair of tweezers or a pin, a needle, just to gently scratch the outside, just to make it, roughen it up a little bit. and this will help with the juice catching on to the coil, to the cotton. This one I'm using, Lychee Libre, the raspberry from Ballistic Badger. I love this juice, really, really good flavour. Very sweet, very tasty. And just to prime up the coil, just going to put a bit in the middle and then put a bit around the outside, around the outside, around the outside, around the outside. Just speeds up the wicking process so you can vape it sooner, so you don't have to stand your tank and your mod for half an hour. But you don't need to put too much inside there. You don't want to pump loads in, otherwise it would just go into the deck, into the base. So just a little bit, just a few drops. There we go. Nicely. And then putting it back together, put the top on, and it goes together really easy. Like I said, minimal parts. You've only got 2-3 parts to put in here. And screw it on tight. Push the top over. And then we're just going to pump the juice in. And it's really, really easy to do this bit. I'm not even going to have to speed it up. Look, I'm doing this in real time. A couple of good pumps and it is filled. There we go. There. And then close off the top. If you get any excess drippage, just wipe that drippage off. There we go. And what we'll do is I'll put this on a mod and I will use my Mechman for this one. I'm loving this mod at the moment, really nice. Let's grab it. There we go. And these coils are supposed to be run at 60 to 80 watts, so I will leave the coil to soak in for 5 or 10 minutes and I will join you back up top and I will let you know what I think. Do I like it? Do I love it? Do I loathe it? Do I hate it? Do I think it's prehistoric? It's actually something quite special. We're going to start off with the cotton, the coils. It now includes, or it's combined with seagrass. And I've been doing my research and there are something like 60 different types of seagrass. I don't know which type is used for this and I don't want to get into the specifics, but I know what seagrass is used for. It's used for ropes and weaving and things like that as well. I know it's a porous object. I know that it can help, like cotton, retain moisture. Do I notice any flavour difference? No, it's no different in cotton, but I can tell though that my coil has lasted longer. As you saw in the down below, my coil has been going for about 3-4 weeks, and the only reason I changed it was because of the video. I wanted to put in the new coil and try out this one. That was still going. That's had about 3-4 weeks, and I think I could probably push that a bit more. It had my banana custard through it from Ace of Vapes, and I think I probably could have gone another 2 weeks, week maybe. The coils are compatible with the Falcon tanks, and the Falcon tank was a huge success. So this is a very, very brave step for EHPro and Horizon Vape Distro. But I want to say straight away that they've actually done a very good job of it. But the coil itself, it's holding up. It's doing a very, very good job. So if you're going to take this coil and you're going to now put it into the Falcon tank, I don't think you're going to be disappointed. I think you're making your Falcon tank very, very durable. And you'll increase your lifespan of your juice, your tank, your coil, and so on. I don't notice any flavour difference using seagrass. I don't know how much better it wicks. I couldn't tell you if it's wicking any more efficiently. I do know, though, I've had no leaking issues. When I've sat my tank down for extended periods of time, I've noticed that it's not leaked out or leaked through like some other larger name brands. It's been okay. It's been fine. The coils have been okay. We'll move on to the tank. The tank does come with a TPD glass, which immediately I have to take off and remove because there is no capacity on there. You can't fill that with a realistic amount of juice to last you through the day. It's measly, it's pathetic, but that's just the regulations that we live under, unfortunately. But with this bubble glass on there, not only does it look a lot better and it looks a lot stylish, a lot more stylish, I noticed that this is getting me through a couple of hours at a time. Because I'm chugging away on the tank anyway, I'm probably ploughing through juice faster than I should do. Now, I've only just put this coil in the last couple of hours while I've been doing the review. But I've noticed, though, that this coil over the 0.15 is a lot tastier. The dual is a lot tastier than the single. The single was good. The single mesh was really nice, but I'm finding that the dual has got a better taste, a better vape. It does run hotter, and I prefer a hotter vape anyway. It runs at 60 to 80 watts. I've got it at 60 at the moment on braking. I am looking forward to increasing that wattage, but I'm going to wait a couple of days, wait until it's bedded in a little bit first. We'll start with the airflow. It's got the logo engraved. It's got a nice little Raptor on the side there. And the airflow, what opens on one side opens on another. I'm not noticing any whistling. I do like to close off the airflow a little bit. It's smooth. There's a bit of restriction, which is good for me. To remove and to clean, it's quite simple. There's a few interchangeable parts there just to undo and to wash out and rinse, which is quite nice. You don't have to faff around with any extra loose bits. The drip tips, they are 810 compatible, but I've noticed that some of my drip tips either do or don't go in. And I find this happens with a lot of devices. Some of my 810s do or don't fit in. So you've just got to find ones that do or don't. I'm just going to try another one while I've got it here. This is a quality drip tip, I would say. Oh, there we go. So some of my better drip tips do fit into the top there. So I'm quite happy with that if I want to change them over. You know, but it comes with a nice one on top already. So I'm quite happy with it anyway. To fill it up, it's quite simply slide over, squirt your juice into the kidney hole. There's plenty of room to get your gorilla style bottles in there and to squirt your juice in. And it does close quite easily. I'm not sure over time how firm that is going to stay closed, or if it goes into a pocket or a handbag, if it's going to stay closed. As you can see, it opens quite easy. But as long, I suppose if you put a vape band around the top of it, and I don't like to use them anyway, but if you put a vape band around the top, it will hold it in place somewhat anyway. This is not hybrid safe, and I just want to make this clear, because it is a static pin, it doesn't protrude very much anyway, as you saw in the video, but you should not be putting this onto any hybrid mechanical mods. It is not safe. There is a risk of it pushing up and causing your mechanical mod to short out if it touches both the 510 pin and the screw at the same time. So please do not use this on hybrids. Do not use this on mechanical mods. Make sure that you remember to stay safe, be responsible, or vape responsible. The final thing that I just want to mention is that it's called Raptor, as in Raptor. Not Rapture, as in when they named it, they decided to change it over and they sent out the sample packs with the old name on it. So that's why mine says Rapture. What you will receive on your packaging, it will say Raptor, as in Raptor. Please check out some of our other videos on the page, and as always, click that subscribe button, ring that bell, just so you get any future notifications of videos that we upload. And I appreciate any comments that you might leave on the video. That tells us what you think about the information that we're putting out to you guys. I've been Graham, this has been Vape Underground, and this has been the Raptor. This has been the Raptor tank from EHPro and Horizon Vape Distro. I'll see you all soon. Remember, vape responsibly.